This one says you're not actually annoying and just act like that when you're with Kesh. So this next one says you're low-key a bit spoiled. This one says you're a rich bitch. And in terms of the money that I make from YouTube. Jeez, my Diet Coke is going everywhere. Where's my stickers? There they are. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am filming my first ever mukbang. I know that's a drink, but I have actually got food there. Here, what I am gonna do is chat. Get banged. No.
Ew, is this a paper straw?
I feel vandalized. What I'm gonna do is answer your assumptions and eat food. I think that's the point of a mukbang. I think everyone loves a good old mukbang. It's an excuse to get fat, right? So I asked you guys for some assumptions. You guys have sent some in, so we're gonna talk about that, have a little discussion, eat some food, have a good time. If you are new here, remember to leave a like, comment, subscribe, turn on my post notification bell as well. That way you don't miss any of my uploads. Want to see more of my face? Social media's in the description box. Without further ado, let's move on to the eating food portion. Of the video. Guys, the McDonald's Monopoly is on right now. Imagine if I win Mayfair, that would be the biggest clickbait ever. What did I get? Regent Street and Bench Church. Regent again and Leicester Square. What's this? Whitechapel Road.
Ew.
I put salt on my chicken nuggets. Some of you are gonna get disgusted by me. I love salty stuff. Like, honestly, try putting salt on your nuggets. People used to judge me for that. Best thing ever, honestly. Some people say McDonald's chips are salty enough. I say,
think again, Queenie.
Guys, I used to actually hate eating food in front of people. Like, I would only eat food in front of you if I trusted you. That's how you knew, like, I trusted you if I ate food in front of you. But look at me now doing a mukbang. We've come far, hey? I don't know how people do this because, like, how am I supposed to talk with my mouth full? Sorry, I need to burp. Someone says, you don't even have to try to be pretty. Girls like you are perfect, whatever you do. Okay, so I don't know what you really mean by, like, girls like me, but I don't think anyone is perfect. I think everyone has flaws and everything. Everyone has insecurities. And I think if someone is perfect, then that, like, makes them imperfect. Like, I don't think anyone can be perfect. I think perfection is such a vague word.
My voice just cracked.
Ew. I don't know how I'm supposed to do this because I really want to eat these nuggets, but I'm also trying to talk. You know, I just think perfection is such a vague word and I don't think anyone can ever be perfect. I think everyone has their own insecurities and flaws, and I think perfection has so many different definitions because I think perfection is so dependent on the person. Like, I think perfection is just being completely you and accepting yourself for who you are, and only then can you be the best version of yourself. If you constantly try to be someone else or look a certain way or do something a certain way, you're never gonna be like the perfect version of yourself, in my opinion. But yeah, I think everyone has insecurities, everyone has flaws,
and I'm definitely not perfect.
So this next one says you're low-key a bit spoiled. I don't think I'm spoiled. I think I'm very aware that my parents give me nice things. However, I don't think I'm spoiled. I think there's a difference between being spoiled and having nice things. I think being spoiled is when you don't accept that it costs people money, you're not grateful for it, and you don't really acknowledge the fact that people have put time and effort and money into thinking about it. And I think my parents have spoiled me a little bit, like, growing up, because they always wanted to treat me to nice things, which is really nice of them. But I think they also made it very clear that we had to be grateful and appreciative of it.
Appreciative.
Yeah, I'm aware that they have given me nice things growing up. However, I don't think I'm spoiled. You may think that.
That's great.
That's your opinion. This one says you think you're really pretty. This one says you think you're really pretty. Jesus Christ. This one says you think you're really pretty. That just reminds me of Mean Girls. Like, you know when Regina's like,
so you agree? You think you're really pretty?
You're, like, really pretty. Thank you. So you agree? What? You think you're really pretty?
Yeah, I've drunk way too much Diet Coke and the fizziness is, like, bubbling up in my stomach. Okay, I'll be fine. Oh, these chips are getting cold because I've left them out for so long. Honestly, I've been, like, so insecure throughout so many parts of my life. When I was younger, I was kind of, like, a bit of a tubby kid, like, when I was, like, 10, 11. Oh my god, I just spat everywhere. That just, like, made me feel really insecure from a really young age. Like, I wasn't good enough for some reason. Like, I used to be so insecure. Like, I remember when I was at school not long ago. This was when I was in year 12, like, just before I left. When we were in, what's it called? Registration, like, the thing in the morning before you go to all your classes. We'd do, like, activities sometimes, and they gave us this activity to do where we had to write down three things that we hated about ourselves and three things that we liked about ourselves. And I literally refused to do it because this is what my thought process would be like. It'd be like,
oh, I like my eyes.
And I'm like, yeah, but they're different shapes. I feel like I finally got to a point where I am, like, confident and have learned to love myself. I wouldn't go as far to be like, yeah, you think you're really pretty. I don't think I think I'm really pretty. I think I've just finally know my worth. Yeah, I feel like I'm finally, like, 100% myself.
I'm talking with my mouth full again. That is gross.
Where is my etiquette? This one says you're not actually annoying and just act like that when you're with Kesh. I don't know what you mean by annoying. I don't mean to come off as annoying. If I am annoying, I'm sorry. You don't have to watch my videos. I don't want to annoy you guys. Me and Keisha bring out, like, the worst in each other. We're both quite loud people, especially when we're with each other, because we feel very comfortable around each other because we're, like, best friends. When we're with each other, I feel like our loudness becomes even louder. I don't mean to be annoying. I'm sorry if you think I'm annoying. I don't think I'm annoying, but if you guys think I am, I'm sorry about that. I don't mean to be. Let me know and I'll try and not be annoying, I guess. So the next one says you went to private school. I went to state primary school up until the age age of 7, and then when I was 8, so in year 4, I moved to private primary school, and then I also went to a private secondary school.
And something like causing indigestion, I think I've got like a whole chicken nugget in my throat or something.
Yeah, what I will say about private school, particularly private primary school, was that personally, I did not enjoy it, which sounds so freaking spoiled bratty, because it's like my parents are paying X amount of money for me to go to this like really good school, and I'm just there like complaining about it. The amount of pressure puts you under, because obviously your parents paying this amount of money, you need to get the results for the kids that are going there. So they put the kids under so much pressure when you're like 8 years old to like get this mark in a test, get into this school, like get freaking A stars. I don't know if it was really the place for me. It's because I don't deal well with pressure from other people. And genuinely, the thing that I hate most, more than anything, is letting other people down. And my dogs are going for a bath outside. I'm washing them really loudly. These chicken nuggets are so good, I swear to God. Guys, I went pescatarian for a year, so I only ate fish. And the thing that broke me was the chicken nuggets. Oh my God, I freaking love chicken nuggets. But I'm not sure if it was the best move for me just because of how much stress it put me under. Private secondary school wasn't that bad because like you're a bit older, you can handle the stress more. Obviously everyone's under stress when they're doing GCSEs and stuff. I don't get nervous for taking the exams. I don't care about that at all. What I get nervous for is the results of them. This one says you're a rich bitch. I don't think so. I could not go out any day of the week that I want and go to freaking Gucci and be like, I want that, that, and that. No. And in terms of the money that I make from YouTube, trust me, it is not enough to make me considered rich. It is like a good amount considering I'm 17. Considering all that like I still live at home. I don't need to buy like food, electricity and stuff because I still live at home. Do you know what I remember? When I was younger, I used to never be able to chew with my mouth closed. And I will always remember this episode of Phineas and Ferb when the evil guy, the like scientist guy, was like chewing with his mouth open. He was like, how do people chew with their mouth closed? I don't understand it. And I was like,
I relate to that so much. Like,
oh, I'm focusing so hard to chew with my mouth closed. I can kind of do it now, but like, to be fair, chewing with your mouth open is just as hard, like. Someone says you put out an image of yourself that's bitchy, etc., but you're actually really kind-hearted. I don't know if I put out an image of myself that's bitchy. I am, like, not a bitch. I don't think, at least. Some people may think I'm a bitch, but once I trust you and you are my friend, there is nothing that I will not do for you. I don't think I'm a bitch. I don't know. I think sometimes I can come across as like a bitch because I kind of have like a wall up. If you get to know me, like, you know how I actually am. Someone says you can't go out without makeup. No hate though. I used to be like that. I used to not leave the house without makeup on. I used to hate it. But now I'm fine. Like, I feel like YouTube has really boosted my confidence without makeup. Because obviously I sit in front of a camera with no makeup on like every other day. I'm fine. I don't really care about not wearing makeup out. It just happens that normally I do have makeup on because, yeah, I like wearing makeup in my videos. And majority of the days I will either be like filming or editing. So if I'm editing, I won't wear makeup. But if I'm filming, I will have makeup on. I just don't bother to take it off. I'm not one of those people where I hate the feeling of makeup on my skin. I don't mind it. I can't feel it on. So I never even take it off. Even in my Easter Bunny video that I filmed, I kept that on the whole day because it didn't like, I couldn't feel it on my skin. It didn't affect me, so like I couldn't be bothered to take it off. This one's,
hang on, I'm still chewing.
I need a bottle of water to wash this all down with. I don't know how I'm still eating, by the way. This one says that you were talking to a boy but you aren't telling anyone. Lol. Not right now, but normally if I am ever talking to someone, I don't tell people about it. I hate talking about stuff like that. I don't even tell my friends about it, like not until it's like actually like serious thing. Like, feel like when you speak about something, it makes it more serious than it needs to be, and it makes it more real. And like, I'm very open but private at the same time. I keep talking with my mouth open. I'm so sorry. You know, I just find it very hard to open up to people about things because, yeah, I'm very guarded and I just don't like it. Even in my ear video, I literally start crying in that. I can't face up to just, like, little emotions, which is really pathetic. I feel like such an emo right now. Like, I should, like, feel sorry for Classy. No, I'm fine. What I want to know is, what's your McDonald's order? Today I got nuggets. Tomorrow I might get chicken selects. Not that I had McDonald's 2 days in a row, guys, but I feel like this is my first ever, like, sit-down, like, talky video. Like,
other than the one where I was crying for 20 minutes feeling bad about myself because I had half an ear.
These are all cold now. Have you ever had cold chicken nuggets? They're gross. Yeah, so that's it for today's video, guys. My first ever mukbang. Let me know if you want more chatty type videos. I feel like I never really do them on my channel. I don't really know what you guys like to see. If you like more of this, or if you like more makeup or hair or beauty or what, or style. I could do more style because a lot of you guys like my outfits
for some crazy reason.
Let me know in the comments down below. If you're new here, do remember to leave a like, comment, subscribe. I feel so full, like honestly so full. If you want to see more of my face, social medias are in the description box. So follow me on there if you want. And yeah, I love you guys so much. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye, I love you.